Hey everybody, welcome to Big Squid RC Live. Thanks for joining us this evening. Real quick, I want to apologize for the chat box not working. I know you guys all sort of love that thing and hanging out and talking with us. And we're having some technical difficulties tonight, so you're going to be stuck posting in the comments and you got to reload and everything, and I know that sucks, so sorry about that, but you're going to have to bear with us. I'm blaming Jeff, totally, so feel free to blame our technical guy there.
I have no control over third-party services. I just pick them.
He's still responsible. Still totally responsible. I'd like to thank Proline for being this evening's sponsor tonight. Yay, Proline. We're going to be giving some stuff away here shortly, so we'll talk more about that later. We'll do some introductions real quick. Craig, Crazy Rant Builder Guy. How's it going, Craig?
How's it going? Craig, the Crazy Rant Builder Guy.
You're like lower, your couch is higher or something today. Usually we don't see the couch. It's going, there, hey, there you go. You didn't have to adjust for us. I was just pointing it out, you know. And Jeff, what's going on, Jeff?
I'm really tired tonight. Had a long day at work, so I'm going to just sit back and fall asleep.
Thanks, Jeff.
And I've got no sound effects. Normally I'd be kicking in a ha-ha or something there, but...
Right.
No sound effects tonight.
We're going to have to go old school. Somebody needs, like, you know, two shoes and a piece of wood or something. Oh, man.
Yeah, so hey, guys. Good evening. Hope you like the show. Got some good stuff to give away tonight.
Yep.
That's your cue, Brian.
Hey, back to me. Hi. How's it going? So, yeah, tonight we're giving away some Proline stuff. We are giving away, and I've got a whole box here of things. We are giving away, and I'll go through it all real quick here. Proline Ford F-150 Raptor body. This should be for the Stampede size, I believe. So, yay! Wow, my screen got real darker. What is going on? I guess I'm blocking some light. Hey, so it's all about the Stampede today. So, Proline body. We are giving away a bunch. Obviously, you're going to get Proline stickers, you know, obviously. And a Proline t-shirt. Pretty cool, right? And let's see what else we got in here. Proline hat. Also pretty cool. Check that out. And let's see. Tires. You got to have tires to go with your Stampede. These are Badlands. So, new set of Badlands for you. And to finish it off, the Proline transmission. How awesome is that? So, and this thing fits all sorts of stuff, but, you know, we sort of just geared everything to be a Stampede-ish sort of giveaway, but you guys know it'll fit some other vehicles as well. So, you are set in gold and awesome. So, thanks to Proline for hooking us up with all the sweet stuff, and we really appreciate it. And we will come up with a way for you guys to win this thing shortly. I know we don't have the chat to do our crazy cool, hey, this is how we're going to do it. So you'll probably have to post some sort of answer in the chat or in the comments section below later. So
hey,
if you haven't
like
commented yet.
Back up.
What is it? Is it back up?
Maybe.
Oh, yay. I don't think so. I think it's still down. Yeah. So I highly recommend for you guys joining us, go post a comment right now just to make sure you can post a comment and you're familiar with how the whole commenting thing works. Because later on in the show when we're like, okay, you need to answer this question, and you're like, oh no, I don't know how to do comments, you know, and you're going to lose out on all this cool Proline stuff. So make sure you comment at least once just to test the waters in there. Cool. Anybody got anything to add to that? Anybody? No, we're all good? Sweet.
Those Badlands are gnarly.
Yeah, they are. They're definitely
those gnarly tires. Those will work good on a Stampede.
Yep, heck yeah, sure. And they got all sorts of cool swag. That t-shirt's new and that hat's new. That's some cool stuff. So.
And they're not black, so that way during the summer you can actually wear them and not cook.
I know, right? We keep having the black Big Squid shirts, and we boil out there, and we'll see if we can get that fixed this summer.
That murdered outlook is neat looking and all, but man, during the summer, that can be brutal.
Let's see, who else has got, let's see, Craig's wearing black, Jeff's wearing black. yeah, it seems to be the color choice. We'll go with something cool, though, for the summer. I know Craig's into, you know, maybe we'll do yellow for SpongeBob or something like that. Maybe some Caramel colors.
No yellow.
No yellow?
No yellow, Brian.
We can go red.
Red? Red'd be cool. We'll come up with something. Orange?
Orange.
So nobody hits us on the thing. Speaking of orange, I got one of these in the just recently. That's fun orange right there. If you can't tell what that is, it's one of those cool tickety things. Fun. So yeah, we will not do orange for.
So you got a cool tickety thing?
A cool tickety thing.
Would you like to describe that?
Cool. Not really. Somebody gave me a ticket who claimed I was parking illegally in a place. And so it's actually kind of a good ending to a story. So I parked in this spot for a little while, downtown Chicago. I hate downtown Chicago. It's nothing but trouble. But I had to go there. So parked there real quick, came back, had the ticket on my car. They said I was in the wrong place at the wrong time. And I didn't have my, like, hazard lights on. Apparently you're supposed to have your hazard lights on if you're parked in this spot. And there was no sign saying that you had to have your hazard lights on. So I took a picture of my car, and I took a picture of where I parked, and I took a picture that there was no sign telling me this. And a couple days later, I get in the mail the ticket thing, and it shows, here's a picture of your car, and here's a picture of this sign. And they're all time-stamped, like all the pictures and everything. And the picture of when they took the picture of my car and license plate and the sign was like 45 seconds. So I complained and said, I could walk pretty far in 45 seconds. That sign is nowhere near where my car is. And I sent them a picture that I took of my car where there was actually a pole missing. Like, there should have been a sign maybe there, and there wasn't. And they responded and said, hey, you're right. That sign is nowhere near your car. You're done. And I got off, which was cool. So thank you to the judge who said, you know, way to go. And remember, if you get a ticket or something crazy, take pictures. Because they go, hey, yeah, there's no sign where there should have been a sign. So save myself $60.
And you got
Jeff's
off.
Jeff's hysterical. Jeff seriously needs some sleep.
I don't have my rim shot or anything, man.
I know, right?
I'm desperately Jeff's trying to get the sound effects to work, and I can't get them
Jeff's
to go.
Like bright red. Check him out. He's like, totally. It's awesome.
I need the fart right, sound talk. Effect right now. That just set him off.
Right?
Can't giggle for the next half hour.
Seriously, you got to cut down on the nitrous, man. Let's see. Let's talk RC news, huh? Let's do some news. We have, what do we got? First up, March Bashness. Yay! Got to do our own sound effects now. Yay. So, hey, if you're unfamiliar with March Bashness, get over on the webpage and check it out. We have like 2 or 3 days left for nominations. So go nominate something to be in our Sweet 16 bracket. And, you know, you might win something. We also said, like, if you guys share a bunch of the March Bashness stuff on Facebook, we will give away a car. So all we need is, like, a couple more shares to hit the limit. We said, like, all right, if we get 50 shares or something like that. So go click the share button. And, you know, some lucky person who did the share is going to win an Axial XO. So your odds are pretty good, like 1 out of 50 if you go hit that thing.
So you got to get on the Big Squid Facebook, share the March Bashness post, and then you can win an Axial XO? Is that the way it works?
That is the way it works.
Okay.
That's pretty simple, right? Am I overcomplicating that or something?
Is that March Bashness like kind of down the page on Facebook or no?
It might be down the page on Facebook a little bit. Tomorrow morning I'll post a link. Yeah, I'll post a link to the actual post over there and see if I can make it a little bit easier to share. But it's pretty close. So if you haven't shared or liked it yet, go do it because you could win something. It's totally cool.
Hey, and where's that?
Thanks to Axial for hooking us up with that.
Hey, where did Adam the intern go? Just not showing up tonight?
I don't know. Like, I haven't heard back from him. I don't know what's going on. He's probably watching from somewhere. Or he's got like a pot of cereal or something. I don't know what he's doing.
Because we were totally going to, you know, get on him about the Tumblr page.
Exactly.
You know, see what he was going to do with it, you know, that kind of thing.
I know, right? So I'll give you the real tiny brief rundown is Adam's the new dude in charge of our Tumblr page. Feel free to send some stuff our way or comment or anything like that, what you guys want to see up there. We're not going to treat it like a blog or anything, you know, the Big Squid's the main place. But we've been posting, like, pictures that didn't make the front page of Big Squid for one reason or another. We'll post some over there. It's like the extra. If you need more Big Squid, head on over to our Tumblr page and check some stuff out. I know somebody posted on our Facebook already to please do not repost like the magazines do in Facebook. They said it's the worst thing ever. And, you know, I think all of us here agree. We hate when we see, like, hey, they posted the same thing 7 times. So, and I think they were basically just saying, look, if you guys are going to spread out, don't post the Big Squid thing, and then don't post it on Tumblr, and don't post it here and there. So we're going to try and make the Tumblr stuff a little bit different.
Well, on Tumblr, there's not going to be any news at all, right? Right. Just pictures and just kind of...
Yeah, it's pictures and a couple comments, like where the picture came from. That's
just kind of whatever, you know, Adam feels is cool or whatever.
Right. Yep. That's exactly it. So, but feel free, send us an email if you guys have suggestions like, hey, you guys should really do, you know, post more of these pictures. You know, do you want to see more behind the scenes stuff? Do you want to see, you know, whatever? Let us know. We'll throw it over on the Tumblr page or something like that. So go check it out. It's bigsquidrc.tumblr.com. And that's like TUMBLR. So, check it out. Pretty cool. What else do we have in the news? Oh, speaking of Proline, we've got a little bit of insider info here. Let me pull up my mail real quick, make sure I get all this info right. Proline is going to officially announce in a couple of days that they are selling pre-painted Proline bodies. That's pretty cool. Yeah, hey! We don't know what the official cost is on this. You know, I'm not going to speculate or guess or anything like that. This one, they went for like a sort of a monster Kawasaki green look. We have been assured that they're going to be in other colors as well. And the official announcement comes Friday, I believe. But it looks pretty cool. Paint? It is actual paint on the inside, I believe. Huh. So I'm guessing they're doing like, you know, the cold form thing. It's all printed and then molded, but it looks pretty cool. So
I like that the windows are clear.
Yeah, right? It's a good job for sure, you know. It'll save me some trouble.
Yeah, I'll still paint my own. I'm stubborn like that.
I'm glad they left me some windows to paint my own color. So, yeah, that's pretty cool. Glad to see Proline giving that a try. A lot of bashers are really bad at painting, and at least your ride will look pretty cool. And then, you know, you make it different. You just throw a bunch of Big Squid stickers on there, and you are set, right? What else we got in the news?
Red Cat.
Access thing.
Red Cat. You want to talk Red Cat? We have, what's that thing called? Striker, right? This thing? Is that what you're talking about?
Yes. Yes.
how do you pronounce that?
S-Striker.
Right? So this is the S-Striker.
That's the only Red Cat that I've ever wanted to actually own, right there, the Striker.
I don't want to own it.
I think it's pretty cool, except for the belt stuff.
Except like, it's Red Cat. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I just, you know, the whole belt thing just doesn't do it for me at all. I've had nothing but trouble with belt drive systems. And I will totally agree. It's probably a lot has to do with me, you know, and I abuse and the low maintenance and everything else. It's awesome. But, I mean, taking a look at this thing, Look where that belt is down in there. I do not want to even think about trying to get in there. So Tim, you want one?
Heck yeah, I want one. I want to try to convert it over to off-road, jack it up with some suspension and some knobby tires. I'm not going to leave it on-road. You know, if it can be converted to off-road, I would convert it to off-road. And, I know while Jeff is not a big fan of Red Cat, the one he reviewed wasn't very durable. But on the other hand, Craig reviewed two Red Cats, and they both turned out to be pretty good. So, you know, it might be a 50-50 shot that the Striker might actually be pretty good.
I'm going to have one.
Yeah. I know we got to see this thing back at iHobby, and it was like prototype stage. They wouldn't even let us poke it. They're like, no, don't touch it, you know, because it was like the only one in existence or something like that. But there was a lot of people that, it got a lot of hubbub at the very least. So it'll be interesting. Craig, are you going to do off-road with yours, or are you going to hydroplane yours?
I'm probably neither.
Come on.
I want to see how fast it'll go.
They do sell it. They have a brushed and brushless version.
Extra $100 for the brushless version just doesn't seem like a good idea to me.
That's a skip right there. Pretty much everybody owns a brushless system. They can pop in there.
Yeah.
Or if you don't own one, you can get a low-end brushless system for under $100 and pop it in the other one.
I want to see what like 9,000 will do on 3 cells.
There you go.
See if I can blow the belt off.
I don't even know if there's room for a 3-cell in there, is there?
I can stuff
it. It's a compact car, so.
I can mod.
You can do a small capacity 3S in the battery tray, or you can just duct tape it to the top if it doesn't fit.
You don't need a lot of runtime. I mean, we used to run pretty small batteries in the dragsters back in the day, you know. You don't have to run real long. You just want to run real fast. So,
yeah. I might even try to cram 4S in it.
2S on each side and just get out your duct tape and duct tape them on the side. You're good to go.
I don't think I'm a monster. I'll probably stick it in the box. But
yeah. Well, there's sort of a little guy in there. You know, you could ditch that guy pretty easily. Put a battery in there somewhere and you're good to go.
If Adam were here, he would say that means it's scale.
It's got a guy in it.
If it's got a guy, it's scale.
When we were talking to him at iHobby, they said that back tire is proprietary to them.
Yeah.
That you're going to have to order new tires directly from them because it was, I don't remember they've...
It was the way it was pre-mounted to the rim, and that rim... It's like the only rim in the world or something that would fit that thing.
Well, rim, and I think the tire's 34 mil, 36 mil.
So that's going to be your second mod is the tire.
Well, mine probably won't have the rear tire on it very long. It'll probably get thrown off.
Now, it's three-wheel drive, right? I don't quite remember. It's just rear-wheel drive?
Actually, I don't remember now.
That's three-wheel drive.
Okay.
All-wheel, three-wheel drive.
Wow. That's pretty crazy.
So I'll probably disconnect the front-wheel drive.
Just push it along?
Just burn the back tire off?
It'd be cool if you could do wheelies with it.
You'd have to get some major weight transfer to get it to do wheelies.
Yeah, it looks... That rear wheel is way in the back. It would be pretty tough. But yeah, you know, so we'll see. Apparently it's coming soon or shipping soon, so...
Well, they're in stock right now.
Oh, there you go. We'll see who gets one. See who gets one first. Other things in the news... Do you like how we just happened to have that perfect, Craig? Like, you mentioned it, and there it was. It was awesome. It'll never happen again. But, just real quick mention, we did review the ECX Revenge, the e-electric version, 8-scale buggy. So go check out that review. Adam, the intern, who's still missing, did that one. You can also check out a great Wall Slam video of it online if you haven't seen the YouTube video yet. Quite the bang. Turned out pretty cool. Let's see what else we got. We have
how about that big news from Traxxas?
Traxxas has a new. Are you talking the new body? They've got a new body.
I'm talking about all the parts that they've been taken out of the 1/16th Gravedigger that they're now selling to you to make a four-wheel drive again.
So how do you really feel about that kit? I don't have the picture of it loaded real quick, but what Jeff's talking about is they just released, the rest of the parts to make your Gravedigger four-wheel drive.
The four-wheel drive conversion of the four-wheel drive chassis that should have been four-wheel drive to begin with.
Yeah.
It's got a retail of $60. I don't know. Did that seem like a lot? How much did the Gravedigger cost anyway? Like $150 or $200?
I don't think that thing's that cheap.
Off the top.
Right.
But you get the super cool backpack when you buy the Gravedigger.
You do.
That's true.
that's it's not like buying any other car.
That $15 backpack is worth the $60 four-wheel drive equipment.
Hey, don't knock the backpack, man. The Gravedigger on tower is $229.
Really? $229 for $217.
Yeah. So almost like me not better. So cheap. I actually have. I can't even reach it, but I've got the backpack like right over there. It's awesome. I take it every day to work. So. Throw my laptop in there. Looks pretty stylish.
I can't believe that.
What? No, totally. Here, hold on.
Brian would do that. He actually would.
I'm surprised he doesn't have the turtle shell backpack, too.
See? It's right here. The MacBook Pro fits perfectly. It's awesome.
Now show everybody your Hello Kitty iPhone case.
I don't have the iPhone's just a phone, sorry.
Do you take your work home in that backpack?
Yeah.
Instead of a briefcase.
Exactly.
Do you put your Happy Days thermos and lunchbox in there too?
For the record, briefcases are not cool. Okay? Seriously. Everybody carries backpacks now. So and so mine's going to be a Gravedigger.
Before that, it was the turtle shell.
Turtle shell would be sweet, too. I totally get the turtle shell. Others on my list were the Yoda. Have you seen the Yoda backpack? I totally dig that one, too. So
he has the Vanilla Ice Hit TMNT power on loop.
There is a Vanilla Ice Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle song?
Yeah, for the second movie, he had a guest appearance in it.
All right, you've just completely topped me. The fact that you even know there's a second movie, like
there's like five movies.
Yeah, well,
there's five turtle movies. I love the turtles, actually.
Oh, here we go. Jeff's coming out right here live.
I used to have when I was little. I had a big collection of turtle stuff.
Like last week, or
yeah.
But Jeff, do you take the turtle backpack to work though? Today?
No, I don't do that.
See? Yeah.
Only Brian does that.
Yeah.
You guys wait. You're all jealous.
One day that Gravedigger backpack will be worth $70.
Yeah. And like 2600 or something.
Right. Not if I keep using it. You know what? When Wrench and I went and saw Monster Jam, I should have brought it with. I could have had it like autographed or something. How awesome would that have been? I can see the guy now. He's like, "So is this for your kid?" I'm like, "No." What's your kid's name? Brian?
I want to see you go through airport security with that.
Totally.
Put it there on the conveyor belt, and they just look at you and go, seriously?
I don't,
how old are you? Seriously?
Yeah, but would they just wave
you
me
a child traveling with you today?
You keeping diapers in that thing, too?
If it gets me through security any faster, I'll totally bring it. I'm completely on board for that. You guys wait. I'm going to have pictures of me next week at the airport. The only problem is it's just not very comfortable. Like, it's just the straps are too small. It's too tiny. It's not like a normal-sized backpack.
It's made for an 8-year-old.
That's the problem.
Not a 40-year-old, an 8-year-old.
Small.
He's complaining the straps are too small.
If it would have been normal size, it would be much more useful. Come on.
Jeez. You better call Peter Vieira and just complain, dude. The straps are way too small for an actual human.
You know what? Now that you mention it, I think that's when Peter stopped taking my calls. After I called to complain about the backpack size, he doesn't take my calls anymore. So. I don't know. It's too bad, too.
You couldn't fit all your
backpack.
You were mad because you couldn't fit enough Pokemon cards inside.
Hey, speaking of which, the Nintendo DS, DS 3DS XL comes out next week. So I will have my Pokemon Nintendo DS.
Yeah, I wish I had my sound effects. I so wish I had my sound effects.
I know, right? You're killing me. Making fun of Pokemon. How dare you? Other things in the news, we had the minivan body. Come on, who's not on board? What'd you say, Craig?
I have to have one of those.
I know, right? There's a lot of people dissing it, but I was totally on board. Like, you know, hook me up. I want it. It's from Pandora RC, and a bunch of people were saying, you know, quality might be not be there or whatever, but, you know.
Well, even in that picture, it doesn't look like it's...
It looks a little flimsy, I think, and that's part of the problem. I think it's so big, you know, it's just really thin plastic, and at that size, it can't support itself or something, but...
It kind of reminds me of that smart car model that Jim Swift made and had at iHobby a couple of years back.
Exactly. Yeah. He could just cut the middle door out of this thing, and he'd have a smart car.
Yeah, I wish somebody in America would pick up Pandora. They've got some neat designs.
They do. They got some really cool stuff that we just don't see around here. So...
It may not be for everybody, but some of that stuff is unique. I know, Brian, you're always looking for the unique stuff. A lot of RCers are.
Yeah, you know, who wants to show up to a bash spot, like, and have the same body as everybody else, dude? Like, you know, half of it's just seriously about the car show factor and showing up with something nobody has or nobody's seen or nobody would want. You know, either way, but at least you're different, so... I'm definitely always on the hunt for something cool like that.
Didn't you put a Sidekick body on a Truggy?
a Suzuki Sidekick 10-scale body Brian put on an 8-scale Truggy. He did the paint job in the parking lot. All right, you bought like a can of white, went out in the parking lot, right. And just painted it. Didn't put the window mask or nothing on, just painted it. And then, like, the Suzuki Sidekick body was digging into the Truggy somewhere. So he just gets out his scissors and cuts, like, the back half of it off. And he ends up, like, zip-tying the body on top.
Dude, you do what you gotta do, man. I mean, seriously, how many other Suzuki Sidekick bodies have you seen since then? None. Dude, Adam would sell his soul for that body right now. It's too bad we trashed it at that event. I mean, that was a one-use body. It was bought for the event that morning, painted there at the event, and destroyed at the event.
There's probably a couple more in that stack.
Oh, yeah, that was the best part. You want to remember how much I paid for that body?
Like $3 or something, wasn't it?
I think it was $1.
$1?
I think I paid $1 for that thing, and it was awesome. So, shout out. I'm going to give the shout out. I'll totally plug Slot and Wing. That was awesome. I love the body, and I could never find another one anywhere else. So, thanks to Slot
and Wing. They have a lot of unique bodies there.
They do. It's awesome. I'm totally digging it over there. Another thing that came out, Jen's Ace, some new batteries. Jen's Ace is some good stuff. They've done really well in all of our shootouts. Their new 70C stuff, I think this is what it was, looks pretty good. You know, we'll see. Hopefully we get our hands on some. But that was a big announcement from those guys recently.
What's the charge rate? 10C?
70 amps.
Yeah.
I think Jeff's making that up.
Yeah, I am.
They didn't list the charge rate on that.
Yeah, I don't think they did. Before Craig goes and, you know, rewires his house to charge him.
It's already rewired. I don't have to worry about that. I have a 3,000-watt power supply now.
He's ready to go.
So that means they have to be really good.
Exactly, right?
Well, I saw somebody on Facebook commented about them and said, why would you buy those when you can get on eBay and buy something for $15? Because the ones that are $15 are crap.
Yeah, no doubt. And, like, the Gen Z stuff isn't expensive. You know, no, it's pretty good price. And it's awesome. I mean, seriously, yeah. Like, every time we've tested their batteries, they've been really good. So
that's all I've been buying lately is Gen Z's LiPos.
No, it's good stuff.
You've been getting them from Hobby Parts, or where do you get them, Jeff?
Oh, my local hobby shop actually stocks them.
Really? Wow.
Wow.
Yeah.
Is this the hobby shop you were live from earlier?
Yeah. AmainSpeedway.com.
It's all about plugs tonight. Tim, you got anything you want to plug?
Oh, that's cool. I got them at your local hobby shop, man. That's about the biggest problem a lot of consumers have getting Gen's Ace is that when they go to a lot of online places, they're always sold out of the popular models. So,
yeah.
That's cool. Your local hobby shop stocks them.
Yeah,
they stock that other line that Hobby Parts carries too, the Sky LiPo or whatever they are.
Yeah.
So, effective and relatively inexpensive batteries are very nice.
Yeah, totally. I'm trying to catch up on comments here. Somebody was saying they really want that Charisma Porsche.
Yeah, the one that I really want.
There's a lot of people behind that, you know, and I think we all have our fingers crossed that someone's going to pick up Charisma here in the States real soon. And
hey, Omar, let's get together and we'll buy a case of them.
There we go. Big Squid's going to be the exclusive distributor. We have 8. A cup Charisma. We're going to bring you into the States. We need 8. Kind of deal you got me. You laugh. Wait till you see the resale price on that thing. By the time I ship in a case of 8, it's going to be like $900 for your Porsche. So
that's a cool car because it's so unique and it's got a lot of historical significance behind it. That's a really neat car. I can see why Jeff and Omar wants one.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, I just wish they had the official stickers for it rather than just the generic made-up stuff that they put on it. But I understand licensing, and I don't even think the company that sponsored the original 959 for the Dakar is still around, but I may be speaking out of ignorance there.
Yeah, I don't know either. I definitely didn't follow that stuff back then, for sure. So
well, I didn't either because I wasn't alive in 19 Or wait, no, it was 86 that it won. Never mind. I was alive.
I think you were alive in 86.
I was 6 years old. Yeah. I was 6 years old then, so I wasn't really following the Paris-Dakar rally much.
It's hard to believe, man.
I was too busy playing with my Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
It's good. Lastly, we posted some stuff about the Corrali car. Let's see. I got some pictures of it here. I have at least a picture of it. Oh, go ahead.
Somebody's asking how they enter the contest if there's no chat, and I'm just going to pick a random name from all the comments.
That's what you're going to do, or is that what you're asking if you should do?
That's what Jeff is going to do.
If you want to do something different.
Okay, so if you're watching right now, the comments are live down at the bottom. Go ahead and leave a comment, any comment. Go down there, go to the comments section, type in something, type in your name. Make sure you include an email address, so that way we can email you after you've been chosen to win. So, since Jeff has said it is so, we will make that the official rules. All you need to do is comment right now in the comment section. And before we're getting ready to log off for the night, before we're getting ready to log off, you will win all the awesome Pearline stuff we talked about, which was the Stampede body and the tires and the transmission and a hat and a t-shirt, stickers and all sorts of other stuff. So huge Pearline package coming your way if you sign up in the comments down there. So get moving. Back to this car. The only reason I was actually mentioning it real quick was the comment that we got wasn't really about the car specifically. It was this and the Speed Passion. Somebody had posted on Facebook, you know, what was the deal? Why are we posting what is considered diehard racer sort of stuff when we're a basher site? And they wanted to know, you know, if it was all about the money involved with advertising. And, yeah, just to let anybody know, we are a diehard basher site. These two companies are probably, you know, they're a long ways away from advertising those cars on our site. You know,
Corrali, they're big advertisers on Big Squid.
Oh, yeah, huge. It's all over the place. So, yeah, it is not about the money. It was, it's more about, we just cover anything and everything. You know, it's the same reason we do the flying stuff. It's the same reason we did the quad shootout. We're bashers. We're into whatever. You know, if someone's got a cool little F1 car we can drive around for a while, great. Odds are good we're going to take it off-road, you know, or do something stupid to it. But we cover anything and everything. You know, we're about all corners of the RC world here.
Well, if you go down to, like here in St. Louis, if you go to where a lot of the guys gather on Sundays to run high-speed bashing, they don't buy the cheap stuff to bash with. They buy the most expensive car they can get their hands on, and it's never used on a track. They just want the highest quality car to bash with they can buy. Some of the guys do show up with the cheapest cars they can get their hands on, you know, used equipment. But I'll tell you what, a lot of bashers, they don't go cheap. They've got the money. So when they see the Corrali, they know it's made out of quality parts. They just pop the bucks for it. So some of these elite racer guys think that only Corrallis get used on RC tracks. They just haven't been to a local bash spot lately, and they haven't seen Corrallis blowing up and down the street at 80 miles an hour or hitting jumps or whatever.
Exactly. You know, and hanging out here, you know, when we hang out with like Gino's crowd or something, when they're doing their racing scene, they're guys that show up with $4,000 and $5,000 FGs. You know, and it's just, you know, the thing's completely blinged out. It's got the best of the best on it, and it's never seen a track or anything else. It's there for bashing purposes only, you know. And
by the end of the day, it gets slammed into a curb at 50 miles an hour, and it's destroyed. The dude comes back the next weekend with even better stuff.
Exactly.
That's some bashing areas, that's what it's about, is showing up with the coolest stuff possible.
I owned a Corrali Fee for about 2 weeks. And I couldn't believe how bad. I bought the Corrali Fee as part of a collection I bought. A guy who's into Corrallis, he saw that I had one, and he asked me what I was going to do with it. And I told him I was going to run it down the street with a 9,000 kV Mamba in it and see if I could get it to go airborne. He actually paid me twice what I paid for it just to convince me that I didn't need to do that. He said it was sacrilege to do that to a Corrale.
So did you do it anyway?
No, I took his money. Yeah. I didn't care that it was a Corrale. I got four TC4s. I just put the motor in a TC4 and did it with the TC4.
Right.
Great. Yeah, the Corrale people are crazy.
They are. They totally are. But, you know, just like we sort of mentioned here, we'll drive anything and everything. So, you know, and that's why we post the stuff. We're not posting it because we're getting paid to post it, for sure. And, you know, we're not posting it because we're going after the racing market. Right. You know, we're posting it because it's news to the bashers, or some of the bashers out there. So that was basically the explanation. Last up real quick. It doesn't have to be last if anybody's got anything they want to jump in there with. This just showed up. We got the Duratrax Nissan, the GTR Nitro car.
A Nissan Getter.
So, yeah. So, looking forward to reviewing this thing. Should be pretty sweet. Can't wait to crack it open and check it out. I know Wrench is already dying to run some Nitro. Hopefully it starts to warm up here. It was cold today. We had like an ice storm yesterday, too, so it's not helping with the outdoor Nitro scene around here. But
Dave wants to know where Cubby's at.
I don't know. Cubby's a man of mystery. He's one of those, you know, some days he pops in, some days he doesn't pop in.
I know where he's at.
Do you?
He's currently summiting Mount Everest.
He's in California right now.
Oh.
So
that's what he told you.
He's climbing some mountain in California.
I thought he was sorting through your Ninja Turtle collection.
And another Brian, not you, Brian, asked, anyone experienced the broken chassis issue with the new LCG Slash? Looking to go 4x4 SCT, but that makes me nervous. If you're worried about that, just get the low C10 SCTE.
You break the chassis on SCTE, and you've really done something.
Yeah.
You've gone well above and beyond. You are Big Squid RC legendary basher status.
Yeah, please send your email in to us, because we'd like to have you join the crew. So, yeah, for sure. We haven't seen that issue. I don't think enough of us have actually had enough hands-on time with the LCG of Traxxas. So I'm going to say we haven't seen it break in half yet, but no guarantees. So. But yeah, if you're breaking that stuff in half, give us a call. We want to bash Fredericks. With you.
Yeah. Sean Frederick said he got his DX4S and was loving it. I think he was the one asking about it a couple weeks ago, maybe. The DX4S, cool. Or somehow radios got brought up, and he mentioned something about, I don't remember, it's too long ago.
I didn't watch last week's show, I wasn't there, so.
And Justin B's in here bragging about how he won the Durango DEX210 we gave away a month back.
Congrats, Justin. Although, not that I know for sure who Jeff's going to pick, but I guarantee, or I'd probably bet that Jeff doesn't pick the guy who just claims he won a car last a couple weeks ago. You may have just hurt your chances. All right, anybody got anything else going on? What are everybody's plans for the upcoming weekend?
Working.
You're supposed to be working. We are, a couple of us are planning on going to the Toledo RC show, if you guys are anywhere in the Toledo area, coming up in a couple of weeks. I think it's called Weak Signals, so check that thing out. See if you can run into us there. We'll be giving away lots of stickers and the usual stuff. But I think we're just walking the show, so if you see us, say hi, stop us, buy us something to drink, whatever. But if you're in the Toledo area, like, that's the show to go to, you know. That's what we've been hearing, is just, it's awesome. So definitely make your way out there. All right, Jeff, time to pick us a winner.
All right, here I go.
No pressure. And for all those people that Jeff doesn't pick, I will post his address later to the webpage.
Yeah. That's all right. I just redirect all my Big Squid email into the empty or the trash can anyway.
So. I meant your real address.
That's all right. I own multiple guns.
are you gonna pick? There's a lot of comments. That's cool.
They just suddenly started turning on.
Suddenly people just started commenting like crazy. So very cool, you guys, to hop on board and start commenting. So.
All right, I'm going to pick, let's see, this name isn't familiar. I'll say Chevis, C-H-E-V-I-S.
Hey, congratulations, buddy. Chevis, or however you want to pronounce it.
You should have.
Do me a favor. If you're watching the show, send an email to me, Brian of Big Squid, and we will hook you up with the awesome prize pack. Good job. Congratulations. Thanks to everybody else who joined us tonight, this evening. We really appreciate it. We're sorry the chat thing didn't work out so well this evening. Jeff will get 40 lashes after the show, and we'll get it all straightened out for next week for sure. Anybody else got anything they want to add real quick before we call it an evening? Take that as a no. So, thanks as always to Tim, Jeff, and Craig, and we will see you guys next week. Thanks for hanging out with us. Thanks to ProLine for being this evening's sponsor. You guys all rock. Later, guys.